In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a very nice focaccia. It's kind of a snacky bread that you can have with cheese or soup or just like a sandwich.
So gently just tip it
to make the focaccia, we need some flour. For this one, we're using what's called Tipo 00 flour, which you can buy in bigger supermarkets. So we're going to have 500 grams of our flour, our dried yeast. I prefer to use this kind of yeast. Our salt, 30 grams of olive oil. And then here I've scaled out 380 grams of water. Just gonna add most of it in, but not all of it. I also have some grated potatoes, but I'm gonna start kneading the dough before I add the potatoes in. So I'm just pulling back a bit of the water and the potatoes. You can knead this dough by hand, or like me, you can use KitchenAid. Start at the lowest speed.
The boiling water creates some steam.
Once the dough starts coming together, we're going to add in the rest of the water.
In your bread, it also helps the natural sugars in your dough caramelize to get a nice brown loaf. We're also going to put our small bread rolls in, and you can see that they also come up.
So now we kneaded the dough for about 5 minutes, and if you have a look here, you can see it's quite a wet dough, which is perfect because you want quite a wet dough when you're working with a focaccia. Now we're going to add in our grated potatoes. So this potato has just been boiled, and adding potato into your dough just gives you a really nice soft finish to your crumb. This is very delicious. So you can see this dough is quite sticky if you were to knead it by hand. This is why I'm using a machine today.
To cool it down,
for about another 3 minutes or so. Now our dough is done kneading, and
you want to place them on the cooling
rack so the air can circulate around. Almost like a batter. Just going to scrape down the sides here. And then we're going to cover the dough and leave it to proof for about an hour and a half. Halfway through, so 45 minutes into the proof, we're just going to give the dough a 4-liter fold. To do a 4-liter fold on your focaccia dough, first dip your hands into some water so they're nice and wet. Then you lift the top of your dough, stretch it, and fold it over.
And
then opposite side, you stretch it and fold it until you just fold it all four sides into the dough. As you can see, your focaccia dough is quite sticky, but you want your focaccia dough to be quite wet, because the more water you have in, the lighter a crumb you're going to get in your final bread. And you might know that a focaccia has big air pockets, which is due to the high water content in your dough. So don't worry about it being very sticky, just power through.